Welcome back, everyone, for another deep dive. Today, we're tackling the world of superbugs.
Yeah, superbugs. It's a scary term for sure.
Absolutely. But before we get too scared, let's just mention up front, this deep dive is based on a fictional case study, though very much inspired by reality.
Right. Yeah. We're taking this from the OpenStax microbiology textbook.
Got a link for that down in the description if you want to check it out later.
Good stuff in there.
So, imagine this. You're a doctor, and you've got this patient, Roberta.
Okay, Roberta.
She just had surgery. Pretty routine stuff, gallstone removal.
Gallstones, yeah, I've heard of those.
But then things go south. High fever, bad abdominal pain, blood in her urine.
Oh, that's not good. Not good at all. Sounds like maybe a UTI.
Exactly. Urinary tract infection. The doctor thinks that's the most likely culprit, especially after surgery. So they do a urine culture to be sure.
Standard procedure. Figure out what bacteria they're dealing with.
Right. And in the meantime, they start Roberta on ciprofloxacin, a common antibiotic.
Yeah, that's usually pretty effective for UTIs.
You'd think so, right. But here's where things get really scary.
Uh-oh.
Roberta's condition just keeps getting worse. She develops a serious kidney infection, pyelonephritis.
Pyelonephritis, that's a step up in severity.
And then it gets even worse. She goes into septic shock.
Septic shock, that's life-threatening.
Exactly. It's clear this isn't just a simple UTI anymore.
Definitely not.
So the doctor orders more tests, a specialized culture, to really identify the bacteria, and a drug sensitivity test.
See what antibiotics will actually work against it.
Right. And the results are terrifying.
Let me guess. Antibiotic resistance.
Bingo. The tests show resistance to a whole range of antibiotics, including Carbapenems.
Those are our big guns, what we use when other antibiotics fail.
And now they're not working.
So we're dealing with a superbug.
A superbug. The culprit. CRE, Carbapenem-Resistant Enterobacteriaceae.
Wow, CRE. Nasty stuff.
Normally, these bacteria live harmlessly in our gut.
Right, part of our normal gut flora.
But if they get into other parts of the body, like through surgery or contaminated equipment.
And they're resistant to most antibiotics.
You've got a serious problem.
A potentially deadly problem.
Sadly, CRE infections are really hard to treat, and a lot of people don't survive.
It's a tough battle.
So Roberta is in a fight for her life. The medical team starts dialysis, gives her IV fluids, and medications to stabilize her blood pressure and prevent clotting.
Trying to keep her alive while they figure out how to fight the infection?
Exactly. And thankfully, they find an antibiotic that works, tigecycline.
Tigecycline, that's one of the newer ones, sometimes effective against these resistant bacteria.
And thankfully it works for Roberta, she recovers.
That's great news, but...
But there's more to this story.
Oh.
Turns out, other patients in the same hospital who had similar procedures are also developing CRE infections.
Oh, no.
And tragically, some of them aren't as lucky as Roberta.
So this isn't just an isolated case.
Not at all. It's an outbreak.
This is where the epidemiologists come in.
Exactly. Public health officials start investigating.
Trying to track down the source of the outbreak.
And they finally find it. Contaminated duodenoscopes.
Duodenoscopes.
Yeah, those are specialized endoscopes used in the procedures Roberta and these other patients had.
I see. So something went wrong in the sterilization process.
It seems so. Even though the hospital followed cleaning protocols, it wasn't enough to get rid of the CRE.
That's unsettling.
Really unsettling.
I mean, if even our best cleaning efforts can't stop these superbugs...
What are we supposed to do?
It's a huge challenge.
It is. And Roberta's case, even though fictional, really highlights the growing threat of antibiotic resistance.
It's a reminder that we need to be careful, use antibiotics responsibly.
And invest in research to find new ways to fight these superbugs.
Absolutely. New antibiotics, new infection control methods.
This is a problem that's not going away.
No, it's not.
So if you're interested in learning more, check out the OpenStax microbiology textbook.
Yeah, it's a great resource.
We've got the link in the description. And join us next time for another deep dive into the world of microbiology.
There's always something new to discover.
Until then, stay curious.
And stay healthy.